Adrenaline Joy. Located in the Cleveland Park area of Northwest D.C. is the Embassy of the Republic of Ghana. One step into the courtyard and visitors are greeted with the country's coat of arms, which bears the national motto, Freedom and Justice. Also featured symbols that date back centuries, known as Indinkra symbols, with a different meaning and a different history and communication behind them. I recently had the honor of taking all this in myself with a visit to the Embassy of Ghana. On this day, the Ghanaian ambassador to the United States, Dr. Baffour, Adjei, Bawuah, greets us in a typical welcoming Ghanaian way.
Your Excellency.
Madam.
Hello.
Welcome to our embassy.
Thank you. It's beautiful.
Well, it reflects the country.
Once inside, an impressive and intricate stairwell stands out, along with artifacts from the West African nation. The base of the stair features hand-carved seats, stools reserved for chiefs, and drums. His Excellency explains the deeper meaning behind the staircase and its functionality.
It's never that strict. You have to swirl around once in a while and make sure that you take very good care coming down the staircase. Sometimes I think that maybe the designer wanted to make sure that once in a while somebody has a wedding here, because it would be good to show somebody's wedding dresses.
Absolutely. The embassy pays homage to its past leaders, including Kwame Nkrumah, the first prime minister and president of Ghana, who led the nation, formerly known as the Gold Coast, to independence in 1957. The embassy's ground floor is home to colorful and intricate silk thread art by Ghanaian artists. Also, beautiful wood carvings can be seen everywhere, and more Adinkra symbols. Also on display, the interwoven silk and cotton fabric known as kente cloth. These examples would only be worn by those in high standing. The embassy is also, of course, home to the ambassador's office.
So this is where you do the business of Ghana.
Yeah, this is where the business takes place.
The same size as Great Britain, with about 35 million people today, Ghana, the ambassador tells me, is on track and doing everything right.
And we haven't been the kind of country where, one group, hits the other and the other group hits the other. And therefore, we have had a certain kind of unsurpassed internal stability for all the time that we have been independence.
In a darker history, 2019 marks 400 years since the first Africans were brought to America, forced into slavery. Many of the men, women, and children taken from the Ghanaian coast. This year, the country of Ghana is hosting the Year of Return in an effort to recognize the contributions of African Americans and to bring Americans and Ghanaians closer together.
Well, we believe that Black Americans and Ghanaians are brothers and sisters. So Ghana is their home.
After long work hours put in at the embassy, the ambassador often continues his diplomatic duties at his private Potomac residence, where once again, we are welcomed in.
Hello.
Hi.
The grand foyer serves as a reception area for visiting heads of state and other diplomats and guests, but every room is beautiful. We couldn't help but be distracted, though, by the smells coming from the formal dining room, where executive chef Francis Otu had prepared a few dishes typical of the Ghanaian culture.
The last dish we have is our famous jollof rice, but this is not a Nigerian jollof rice.
Well, now I've heard that Nigeria represents with the jollof rice.
No.
That's a lie.
No, it's a lie. Because I won the embassy chef challenge a year ago with the jollof rice.
With the jollof rice from Ghana.
You want to try any of the dishes?
Oh, I want to try all of them.
Okay, great. Okay.
After all, everyone, including the ambassador, knows a good meal can go a long way.
If food tastes good, then of course whatever follows is always going to be very congenial.
That was just a wonderful day spent with the ambassador. And for me, we talked about the personal thing, right? For me, the story is really coming full circle, because here I am at his residence with the current ambassador, His Excellency, to the United States. But when I was 10 years old, I was actually in Accra, Ghana, with my grandparents, and I was with the former ambassador. Of course, that is Shirley Temple. Black, that's me with the Shirley Temple curls, and my grandparents and my uncle being received by the Ghanaian, well, the U.S. ambassador in Ghana 43 years ago. So it was just a really special day to be there and to be able to tell the ambassador that story and to come full circle. And I feel like, It's kind of an amazing life, and thanks for the opportunity of letting me go in here today.
It's very cool. Thanks for bringing us the look inside as well. I'm extremely hungry right now. After
seeing that
feast that was laid out.
Let me tell you something. And we spoke about how welcoming Ghanaians are and the hospitality, and he was not joking. He packed a meal and dessert for both Ronnie McRae, the photographer on it, thank you, Ronnie, and myself, and we ate it. And we ate it before we got out of the parking lot.
I believe it. Great insight into some of the history there as well. And for folks who don't know, Ghana has one of the best coastlines in Africa.
Gorgeous, gorgeous. Yep. So anyway.
It's 8:23 right now. Thank you, Allison.